Hello, my name is Jovan, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the new layered portraits, which is a feature added to Dialogic 2 Alpha 15. It's made by the amazing Cake, who's been doing lots and lots of cool stuff for Dialogic. And basically, it's a portrait scene which allows you to combine multiple sprites to form one portrait, and then from the timeline, hide and show some of those sprites, so you can easily toggle on and off or switch between different expressions or clothes. And I think that's really cool, and it's pretty easy to set up, actually. So let's do that. Alright, so I already have a character set up here, and this character is called Agustina, and the portrait, and now we are going to set the scene to be a layered portrait scene. But this layered portrait scene, we will have to make a scene. So when I click this, it's going to prompt us to save the scene, and I'm going to save it to this Agustina folder, and it's going to be named layered portrait Agustina. That sounds good. So save that, and it's created a new scene and a script. And I can open that scene by clicking this little button here. Of course, I could also double-click that, but I'm going to use this. And you can see this is an empty scene. It has a couple of notes, but nothing is visible yet. So let's get started putting something in. So you can see there's a couple of things called layers. And the first thing here I'm going to actually call base. So the base is going to be our base image. And this character, by the way, is free. You can find it on itch. It's called Agustina. It's some RenPy thing, but you'll have to extract it from a Photoshop file, so that's a bit annoying. I already did that. You probably have your own characters, actually, but yeah. So I'm going to use this, and you have that base, and then we have groups. You'll be wanting to use groups for everything where you have variations and where you might want to switch between different ones. We have this for the eyes and the mouth and the eyebrows and actually even clothes. So I'm going to call this first group eyes. And then in there, this layer, I'm going to call eyes open. And then we're going to set up the image. Where is it? Eyes open. Wow, there's many eyes. I'm not going to set up all of these, just a few to show you. Let's set up cry, because that's an emotion. And another one, and we're going to call this one wink here. And you can see they're all overlaid over each other now, so I'm going to hide these two for now. And you're going to want to name these well, just because we're going to use them later. So let's add another group. A group is just a node 2D. This one could be mouth. And yeah, I'm just going to repeat the same thing I've been doing here for a while. I think you get the idea. And lastly, I'm going to add a group for the clothes. There are not so many clothes here, actually. But the only special thing about this is that I'm going to add one of these sprites, which I'm just going to call underwear. That's just a special case in this case, because I'm not going to add a sprite to this. The underwear is part of the base. But if we switch to underwear, we want to have all the other clothes switched off. So I don't know what they're called. We have swimsuit. Alright, and when I hide any, that should not be the default. Like, maybe actually I want to have outfit one by default. Alright, and yeah, the scene is fully set up. I think all the names are correct. And now we can switch back to Dialogic. This is all here already. Nicely visible. And now let's use it in a timeline. So I have a timeline already set up here that makes Agustina join and then updates her. So we're going to use both of these to communicate with the scene. And we're going to use this extra data field. Extra data is always something that communicates with the portrait scene. And what the portrait scene does with it is totally up to the scene. So if you make a custom scene, this is the way to interact with it. But this scene has a really nice syntax that we can use, and it has three commands mainly. That's show, my god, hide and set. Now in this case, show and hide don't really have a purpose because we don't have things that we just want to toggle on and off. We always want eyes, mouths, and eyebrows. We just want to switch between them. And the switch command is set. So if we do set eyes and then open, then it will not only show open, but it will also hide all other sprites in that group. And we can chain a couple of these commands with set mouths, mouth sad, and then set clothes, let's say swimsuit. And if we now start a timeline, I'm hoping that this will all work. We have her here with open eyes and a sad mouth and a swimsuit, and it just works very well. And we can do the same in the update. We can do set eyes wink, set mouth laugh, and set clothes outfit 2. Let's go for the correct. Oh my god. Outfit 2. And now that will update it. And there you go. I think that we can just take a look how this looks in the text view. You can see the extra data is just a parameter, and that's what we put in. So yeah, I hope this works for you and makes it easier for you to create nice and great games. If you want to support Dialogic or me making these videos, feel free to donate via the Patreon or Ko-fi. You can also make one-time donations there, but just keep using Dialogic, and I hope you have a nice day. Bye!